James Arthur.
What's happening?
So good to see you.
Good to see you too.
And I feel like you always look so composed.
Do I?
Yeah, even though your life is hectic because you just got back from NYC, right?
Yeah, NYC, yeah. I don't know how I look, but I'm probably always having an internal breakdown or something.
But you're like a swan, though. So you're gliding, but it's all...
I'm just sort of breezing through at the minute. I'm all right. Feel good.
Right. So the new single, Falling Like the Stars.
That's right.
What's the 411? Tell me everything.
Well, this album that I'm bringing out, because I'm sick of talking about myself, I'm just... You know, like, Say You Won't Let Go. Do you remember that song?
Mm-hmm.
Global hit. No big deal.
We were into it on my show. Yeah, thank you very much. Yes, I remember it.
A billion
Radio
streams.
Radio support, hello.
Not many streams, just a billion streams.
It's a global hit, you might recall.
But, yeah, the sort of the nature of that song was, like, from my imagination. It wasn't necessarily from my own life. So it was, you know, I've made a conscious effort to make this album, you know, about other people's stories and trying to get into the heads of other people. So yeah, like that's kind of the theme of the whole thing, and this song is kind of, it feels like Say You Won't Let Go Part Two,
okay.
In the sense that it's talking about, you know, just being in love and just, you know, how that feels and how passionate that can be.
Love that. Mm. And the album.
Yes.
We're waiting for the album.
Yeah, it's been longer than I thought it was going to be. That's just because I've kept on writing and just kept on coming out with.
So you must have a double album ready then.
Well, there's a lot of material. Yeah, I'm having to sort of trim away a few things that. So initially it started off being this kind of like experimental thing where I wanted to surprise people and come out with stuff that was outside the box, or which just wasn't like typically, you know, the stuff that you'd expect from me. And I got halfway through and just, you know, the kind of classic James Arthur songs were the ones that were, you know, getting the most reaction. I just thought, well, let me make an album that is just the best of what I do, and then we can thread the little bits of, you know, my other interests, my hip hop influences, my other, like, the things that I'm, you know, the other things that I want to show of me into just the best possible album, like 10 Say You Won't Let Go's on this record. And Falling Like the Stars is just like, you know, one of those kind of acoustic bangers, I think.
So you've got You Won't Let Go Part Two, and then 10 other ones, and the trimming, and the remix. So when's the album out?
Yeah.
No.
I'm just putting off the question. It's going to be after the summer. After the summer.
No one rescued you from the sidelines, yeah. So I think you could say after summer, September.
I was getting a couple of looks there. So.
No, that's fair enough. Well, that's good, though, that it's coming. It's good that you've got too much material, because not a lot of people can say that.
Yeah, no, I've spent 2 years writing, so I've got a lot of stuff. I did a lot of stuff in America with some like wicked producers.
So you've been giving Lewis Capaldi loads of love on Twitter.
Yes.
Would you love to work with him? Because I feel like you'd have really complementary kind of like vocal tones together.
Yeah.
Wouldn't you? You'd kill it on a record.
I think that'd be a lot of rasp on one song. Be a lot of testosterone on one. Is that him now?
He's there now. Oh, my God. He's
you're
so keen.
You're right, Lewis, mate. You're right.
Go on, Capaldi.
No, he's wicked. I taught him everything he knows.
No, but you would be good together, wouldn't you, on a track?
I think so, yeah. I mean, without a doubt.
Be really people, nice people to put it out excited. There. So you've just done a song for Game of Thrones.
Yes, I did.
Stop it.
I did a song for Game of Thrones.
Are you a big fan of Game of Thrones?
Big fan of Game of Thrones, yeah. I was a latecomer to Game of Thrones, but yeah.
I'm so late, I'm not even on it yet. You're not even on it? Season.
It's too late now.
All I know is that people are saying, not today, on Instagram. I don't even know what that means.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
That was a line that I was a bit... I'd rather use, because that seems to be the line they use in like Fast and the Furious, stuff like that. Not today.
Like, but hashtag.
It kind of works in Game of Thrones somehow. But yeah, it's a big deal, the not today thing.
And what's the craziest thing that's ever happened to you on stage?
Craziest thing? There was one radio DJ dared me to go out on stage with my flyers undone.
Why?
And,
who? What DJ?
It was from one of the other stations. Once I'd walked out on stage, which was the dare, I was then meant to zip her up.
But you forgot.
And yeah, so.
So did you let it all hang
nothing,
out? Someone else did that. Slash did that, didn't
nothing
he?
Popped out. I made sure everything was nicely tucked. But the press the next day just had a field there. They were like, James Arthur was flying low. James Arthur.
We get that on Google.
His Willy was all unsure. There was a lot of unfair media that followed that.
Craziest moment ever, like you were like, OMG.
It's a really good question. I always say when I made the Miraculous comeback, I always say that. I think that's probably it is like
Well, when you thought it all gone pizza.
I'll never forget the day. Like on the same, everything happened on the same day. For like 2.5 years, I was like, I'm done. I'm on the scrap.
What dates were these? Because this is nice. Let's go back.
This
in
was
time.
Like this was. I mean, when did I release
that? You did X Factor, that right? You won.
What
year was
hit
that?
Say you want, like, God, it has a billion streams. When did I release that? That was.
Is that a billion streams? You don't need to keep promoting it.
September 16th of September it was. So it was probably like a week prior to that. So the first week of September 2016.
Right.
And I'm sitting in my flat, and I'm about to release this song. We tried to get a label in the UK to distribute the song, and no one would. I was sort of blacklisted, effectively.
Well, because you're out of order, weren't you?
I was
you said
out of order.
Things.
I was a bit of a naughty boy, yeah. And I was lucky enough to have Sony, Columbia, and Germany, put all the money into me releasing, and it came out, and it flew to number one on iTunes at the time, and then all the labels came in, and obviously then I re-signed to Psycho.
And you were like.
That happened on the same day. Psycho asked me to come back. They asked me to perform on X Factor, which I thought was, you know, never going to happen. Why would that ever happen again? After
did the Cowmeister get on the blower?
He did, and he was very humble, and he was, you know, thank you very much for like accepting us again. We made a mistake, and then it was like, oh, you've been A-listed on all the radio stations. All on the same day, this all happened for me. So it felt like. You know, like all my dreams had come true, and like, because I'd spent 2 years thinking I'm done. That's me finished. So.
What was the biggest lesson that you learned around that time?
The biggest lesson I learned was self belief, just not giving up. I mean, the power of your belief system is unrivaled. You know, the things you can achieve. I mean, it's very cliche, believe, conceive, achieve, all that stuff. But
yeah,
it really did happen for me. All of my visions were manifested and they came to be, so.
I love that. This
November, Hits Live is going on tour. See the biggest hits live in Liverpool, Birmingham and Manchester. Book your tickets now at hitslive.co.uk.